Hi friends, today I am giving a lecture on implementation of basic gates by using universal gates. So the commonly used basic gates in switching theory and logic design are AND gate, OR gate and NOT gate. The commonly used universal gates in switching theory and logic design are NAND and NOR gates. So NAND and NOR gates are called as universal gates because so any gate output can be obtained by using these two gates, then we can say that these two gates are called as universal gates. Okay, now we have to implement the basic gates by using universal gates. Okay, first one is implementation of AND gate using NAND gate. So, we have to implement the output of the AND gate by using the NAND gate. Okay, what is the output of the two input NAND gate? So, A and B are two inputs that are applied to the AND gate. Then what is the output of the AND gate? AB. Okay. So now we have to obtain the output AB by using the two input NAND gate. How many number of NAND gates are required to get the output of AND gate? So two NAND gates are required. So this is the logic diagram. So A and B are two inputs that can be applied to the NAND gate. Then what is the output? AB whole bar. Okay. Now we have to require the AB from AB whole bar. Again one more NAND gate is applied. So AB whole bar can be applied as input for the two input NAND gate. So then what is the output we are required? AB bar, AB whole bar, whole bar. So then AB. So this is the output of the AND gate. Okay. So how many number of NAND gates are required to get the output of the AND gate? Two NAND gates are required to get the output of the AND gate. Next, second one is implementation of OR gate using NAND gate. So now what is the output of the two input OR gate? A and B are applied as input for the OR gate. Then what is the output? A plus B. A plus B is the output of the two input OR gate. Okay. Now we have to implement the output of the OR gate A plus B by using NAND gate. So this is the circuit diagram. So A can be applied as input for the NAND gate. So then the output is A bar. Okay. Next, B can be applied as input for the two input NAND gate. Then what is the output? B bar. So B into B whole bar. So there is nothing but B bar. Here A into A whole bar, here A bar, here input is A. So A into A whole bar, that is nothing but A bar. B into B whole bar, the output is B bar. Okay, now from these two outputs, then we have to obtain the output of the OR gate. So these two inputs are applied to the another NAND gate. So then A bar into B bar whole bar. So that is nothing but A bar whole bar plus B bar whole bar. So that is nothing but A plus B. Okay. To implement the OR gate by using NAND gate, how many number of NAND gates are required? So three NAND gates are required to get the output of the OR gate. Okay. Next, third one is implementation of NOT gate using NAND gate. So now we have to implement the NOT gate. So NOT gate can require only one input. Okay, so one input can be applied to the NAND gate, then what is the output we are getting? A bar. Okay, so here what is the output of the NOT gate? Suppose A can be applied as input for the NOT gate, then what is the output? A bar. So now we have to implement the output of the NOT gate A bar by using NAND gate. Okay, so this is the circuit diagram. A can be applied as input for the two input NAND gate. That is nothing but A into A whole bar. That is nothing but A bar. So this is the output of the NOT gate. So to implement the NOT gate by using NAND gate, how many number of NAND gates are required? Only one NAND gate is required to implement the NOT gate. To implement the OR gate, how many number of NAND gates are required? 3 NAND gates are required. To implement the AND gate, how many number of NAND gates are required? 2 NAND gates are required. Next one is implementation of AND gate using NOR gate. Now we have to implement the AND gate by using NOR gate. What is the output of 2 input AND gate where A and B are 2 inputs that can be applied to the AND gate? Then the output of the AND gate is AB. So now we have to implement the output of the AND gate AB by using NOR gate. So for that purpose, we have to require 3 NOR gates to get the output of AND gate AB. So this is A can be applied as input for the 2 input NOR gate. So then the output is A into A whole bar. So then the output is A bar. Now B can be applied as input for the 2 input NOR gate. So then the output of this NOR gate is B into B whole bar. So that is nothing but B bar. Now the output of the first NOR gate, the output of the second NOR gate, that can be applied to another NOR gate. So then the output is here A bar and B bar can be applied as input for this third NOR gate. So then the output is A bar plus B bar whole bar. So that is nothing but AB. So this is the output of the AND gate. So there are 3 NOR gates are required to implement the AND gate. Okay, next one is implementation of OR gate using NOR gate. So now we have to implement the OR gate output by using NOR gate. So here we have to apply 2 inputs A and B for the NOR gate. So then for the OR gate, the output is A plus B. So now we have to implement the output of 2 input NOR gate A plus B, 2 input OR gate A plus B by using NOR gate. So for that purpose, we have to require 2 NOR gates. So here A and B are 2 inputs. These 2 inputs for the NOR gate. So then the output is A plus B whole bar. So now we have to require A plus B from A plus B whole bar. Again, we have to apply another NOR gate. So then the output is A plus B whole bar whole bar. So that is nothing but A plus B. So this is the output of the OR gate. So how many number of NOR gates are required to get the output of OR gate? So there are 2 NOR gates are required to get the output of OR gate. Next, implementation of NOT gate using NOR gate. So here we have to implement the NOT gate by using NOR gate. So the output of the one input NOT gate is A is applied as input for the one input NOT gate, the output is A bar. So now A bar is the desired output of the gate by using NOR gate. So how many number of NOR gates are required? Only one NOR gate is required. So A can be applied as input for the NOR gate. So A into A whole bar. So that is nothing but A bar. So A bar is the output of the NOT gate. So in this way, we have to implement the basic gates by using universal gates such as NAND gate and NOR gate. Next one is implementation of XOR gate by using NAND gate and NOR gate. So we have to implement XOR gate by using universal gates such as NAND gate and NOR gate. Okay, the output of XOR gate, two input XOR gate is A bar B plus AB bar. Okay, now we have to implement the output of two input XOR gate is A bar B plus AB bar by using NAND gate. So how many number of NAND gates are required to implement XOR gate? So that is 4 NAND gates are required to implement the XOR gate. So this is the logic diagram for implementing the XOR gate by using NAND gate. First, A and B are applied as input for the 2 input NAND gate. So then what is the output? AB whole bar. So now A can be applied as input for the one input for the NAND gate 2. NAND gate 2. And what is the output of the first NAND gate? That can be applied as a second input for the second NAND gate. For the second NAND gate, what are the inputs? One input is A and another input is output of the first NAND gate. So that is AB bar. So then what is the output of the second NAND gate? A into AB whole bar, entire whole bar. Next, what is the input for the third NAND gate? Third NAND gate, one input is B and another input is output of the first NAND gate. So then what is the output we are getting? B into AB bar and then whole bar. So these two inputs are applied for the input for fourth NAND gate. So then in this way we are getting the output as A bar B plus AB bar. That is equal to A exclusive or B. That is the output of XOR gate. How we are getting? A into AB bar whole bar into B into AB bar whole bar entire whole bar. So this term can be treated as A, this term can be treated as B. AB whole bar, AB whole bar can be written as A bar plus B bar. This is A bar, this is B bar, A bar plus B bar. So again, so this term can be written as A into AB whole bar plus B into AB whole bar. Again, here AB whole bar can be written as A bar plus B bar. Here AB whole bar can be written as A bar plus B bar. So now multiply A into A bar plus A into B bar plus A bar B plus B into B bar. Here A into A bar is equal to 0. B into B bar is equal to 0. Now the output is A bar B plus AB bar. That is equal to A exclusive or B. So this is the output of XOR gate. Okay. So how many number of NAND gates are required to implement XOR gate by using NAND gate? So that is 4 NAND gates are required to implement XOR gate. So this is one of the most important bit in gate examination point of view. Next, implementation of XOR gate using NOR gate. So here the output of the two input XOR gate is A bar B plus AB. A bar B plus AB bar. Now we have to implement the output of XOR gate by using NOR gate. So then this is the circuit diagram. So here first A and B are applied as input for the two input NOR gate. So then what is the output? A plus B whole bar. Next, this is the first NOR gate. This is the second NOR gate. This is the third NOR gate. This is fourth and this is fifth NOR gate. So then what is the output of the second NOR gate? So the input for the second NOR gate is A. So A plus A whole bar can be written as A bar. Next, what is the input for the third NOR gate? That is B. So B plus B whole bar. So then the output of the third NOR gate is B bar. So these two output of the second NOR gate, the output of the third NOR gate, that can be applied as input for the fourth NOR gate. So then the output is A bar plus B bar whole bar. This can be written as A plus B whole bar. A plus B whole bar can be written as A bar into B bar. So that is A whole bar, A bar whole bar into B whole bar, that is equal to AB. Okay, the output of the fourth NOR gate is AB. Okay, what is the input for the fifth NOR gate? One input is output of the fourth NOR gate AB. The second input is output of the first NOR gate A plus B whole bar. So these two inputs are applied for the fifth NOR gate. So then this is the output is A exclusive bar P. So how it can be solved? So here one input is AB plus A bar plus B bar, A plus B whole bar. So entire whole bar. So these two inputs are applied to the fifth NOR gate. So then the output can be written as AB plus A plus B whole bar, entire whole bar. So this term can be treated as A, this term can be treated as B. A plus B whole bar can be written as A bar into B bar. A bar is nothing but AB whole bar into B bar is nothing but A plus B whole bar whole bar. So this term can be written as A bar plus B bar into this term can be written as A bar whole bar is equal to A. That is A plus B. So after multiplying these two terms, then we are getting A bar B plus AB bar. So this is the, in this way, we have to achieve the output of XOR gate by using universal gate, NAND and NOR gates. Next, we have to implement the XNOR gate by using universal gates. Okay, first one is implementation of XNOR gate using NAND gate. So we have to implement the XNOR gate by using NAND gate. The output of two input XNOR gate is AB plus AB whole bar. So this is the output. Now we have to implement AB plus AB whole bar using NAND gates. Okay, so up to this point, this is the implementation of XOR gate by using NAND gate. Again, we have to add another NAND gate. So then the output is AB plus A bar B bar. Sorry, AB plus A bar B bar. AB plus A bar B bar using NAND gates. Sorry. Next, implementation of XNOR gate by using universal gates such as NAND and NOR gate. First one is implementation of XNOR gate using NAND gate. So now we have to implement XNOR gate by using NAND gate. The output of two input XNOR gate is AB plus A bar B bar. So now we have to implement AB plus A bar B bar using NAND gate. Okay, so up to this point is implementation of XOR gate by using NAND gate. So to obtain the required output, again we have to apply one more NAND gate to get the output AB plus A bar B bar. That is nothing but XNOR gate output. Okay, so how many number of NAND gates are required to implement XNOR gate? That is 5 NAND gates are required to implement XNOR gate. So here A dot A exclusive NOR B can be written as A B plus A bar B bar. Okay, next one is implementation of XNOR gate using NOR gate. So now we have to implement XNOR gate by using NOR gate. The output of 2 input XNOR gate is AB plus A bar B bar by using NOR gate. We have to implement AB plus A bar B bar by using 2 input NAND gate. So up to this point is implementation of XOR gate using NOR gate. Now we have to add another 2 input NOR gate. So to get the required output, so AB plus A bar B bar. So that is nothing but A exclusive OR B whole dash. So that is nothing but AB plus A bar B bar. So this is the implementation of XNOR gate by using NAND and NOR gates. So thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel name. So Dibbela Srinivasarao. Dibbela Srinivasarao. So thank you.